something.
Must be wildlife.
I don't guess elk.
Well, it'd be my guess to elk or mountain goats. That is an elk on the left hand side.
Oh, look at those.
Huge rack. This video is brought to you by Sutco Transportation, hiring Class 1 flatbed and wood chip Super B drivers in BC's Lower Mainland, Okanagan, and the Kootenays. To apply, go to sutco.ca, use promo code JuanFan, get an extra $100. Good morning. Welcome to Jasper.
Good morning.
I am very congested, sore throat, not sick per se, I've just damaged my throat.
I think that makes you sick.
No, that's not sick. Like, I don't have a cold or a flu or anything like that. So I'm not going to do much of the talkie. Hopefully just as lots of talkie.
We'll see.
We're doing the bypass around the park entrance. If you're just driving through and not stopping in the park, you don't need a park pass. I was here 2 weeks ago. So same video again. Last 2 weeks ago, we saw one moose. See if we see anything this week.
You never told me you saw a moose.
I saw a moose last time.
Well, that makes me jealous.
Vacation is over. Busy, busy vacation.
We didn't get to everything.
I need a vacation. So yeah, so this is, what is the date?
There's my phone.
So 10:10 a.m.
23rd?
Yeah. July 23rd? It is, good. Oh, those are Mike's sunglasses.
Yeah.
Oh. Is that what the text message is?
Yep.
I've got Mike's sunglasses. Oh, well. Tough luck. He's lost his sunglasses. We met our friends from Manitoba. He's left his sunglasses in my truck. It is 30 degrees Celsius outside.
It didn't feel like it.
It's warm. It's not hot, but it's warm. Highway 16, Trans-Canada, Highway 16, also the Yellowhead. Highway 16 is the Yellowhead, and Highway 5 is the Yellowhead. Named after the Yellowhead Mountain. I don't know what the Yellowhead Mountain is named after, though. see the shadow of one of the kayaks over the hood. Kayaking twice. Both my friend and I also capsized once each. So we did some whitewater rafting in the Sunday night. And then we also went again on, it rained like crazy on Monday. So we went the same river, but way further up on Tuesday. And because of the hard rain, the river was a little wild. We didn't scrape the bottom as many places, but it was a little wild. So both of us, different locations, capsized. And we didn't like roll over. We just were stuck at an angle that the river, you know, filled the kayak full of water. Good luck kayaking with a full kayak full of water. It still floats. It's just not stable. Saw the museum. Spent a few hours in there. Some hiking trails.
I went and did fossil casting.
Oh yeah. Jess and the niece and nephew went.
Not niece and nephew, but
you
consider that niece and nephew.
Yeah, niece and nephew.
Like, they're kind of...
Not blood related, but they're my niece and nephew. Went Castle Fosdick. Fossil casting at the museum. Okay, if I see opportunity to pass it to duty. It's doing about 10 below the speed limit. This looks like a good spot. And the big rig would be not a good spot. West Edmonton Mall. Did some roller coasters. The big red one was closed. But by that time, I already had been in the pool too much. That's what I did to my throat. I did some stuff that was a little too aggressive and ingested quite a bit of pool water. And the pool was closed the day before because of too high chlorine levels. And I think I gave myself a bit of chlorine poisoning.
You went public swimming like every day.
Almost every day. Four days in a row we went public swimming.
So yeah, that was your first time on a roller coaster.
First time ever in my life. 45 years old. On a roller coaster. Quite enjoyed it. I wish I had been feeling better at the time. Because I was feeling a little nauseous before going on the roller coaster. The roller coaster didn't help.
No.
But I went on more anyway.
Since you decided to go on, like, the twirly one first. Instead of the easy one.
Well, you gotta go for the craziest one first. It's part of the... Part of the rules, right?
What else did we do? We did bumper cars. Oh, we did the carousel with the kids.
Yeah, a bunch of rides.
Yeah. Fun house.
Overall, I would rate West Edmonton Mall outdated. A lot of the stuff in there is outdated. They need a good update. A lot of it feels like 90s.
We did mini golf. Backlit. Mini golf. Oh yeah, then we spent basically the whole day in the water park as well.
Yep.
And lots of shopping.
for someone that hates shopping, you bought 3 pairs of shoes in a week.
You bought the 1 pair for me? To clarify, it was on sale. You had a heck of a deal for it.
They wear super, super aggressive tread on them. And like, if we go hiking on anything steeper and slipperier stuff, put those boots on. It's hiking, not really boots, but hiking shoes. They're gonna have traction.
Didn't you pay like $70 for them or something? I don't
remember. No, I paid like $50 for them.
50.
And the original price was 160 something.
Yeah.
165 or 166, something like that.
Unless it's cheapest pair of shoes. I was looking for the right sandals.
Yeah, it's hard to find a sandal that you like and comfortable.
This lady brought out at least like a dozen pairs before I settled on a pair.
I bought 2 pairs. Or 1 pair of boots and 1 pair of shoes. I almost bought a pair of sandals before realizing I already have a pair here and another pair at home. I'm like, I don't need a third pair of sandals.
Finally throw away the ones that mother might be at home.
No wildlife yet. Okay, cruise control. Toyota cruise control can be buggy. Most of the time I just turn it off.
Water
slides. Get a lot of water slides. You know those that you drop down, you have to stand on top of a platform and almost on the platform underneath your feet opens? Yeah, that's exciting.
Is that what that one was as well?
The corkscrew one.
Well, no, the corkscrew is one of my one.
No.
You did like a big loop.
I thought that was Cyclone.
Yeah. I didn't know Cyclone was that.
Oh, yeah.
Vertical drop. Oh, boy. That makes it even worse.
Yep, vertical drop. Nephew wanted to go on that one. It's like, no, you don't weigh enough to go on it.
It's one that goes like a big loop in there, like a big. Yeah. There's no way I was doing it. I went on the corkscrew and then I went on one that requires a tube. SBS. I think I don't know.
Something board, slide board or something like that?
Oh, yeah, slide board, yeah. That's what it was.
The slide board one was actually really relaxing and fun ride down.
It was.
It wasn't super fast. It didn't have any drops. It was just you're in just for a relaxing time, do the slide board.
Yeah.
Or the tube.
Oh, and of course we did the wave pool a lot.
Yeah, the wave pool was fun. There were some idiots trying to surf the wave with their tubes. And it's like, you don't do that if the wave pool is full of people. If it's empty, go ahead. Like, do that surfing thing. It looks like a lot of fun. But when there's hundreds of people in there, you're literally bludgeoning all these little kids.
That whole water park, they say you can hold up to 5,000 people. And it was like a couple thousand people in there.
Yeah.
It's a big thing. It's actually the second largest indoor pool in North America. Definitely was fun.
It was fun. Definitely fun.
And we paid half price for our passes too, so that was.
Excuse me.
Blurry should have stayed out. made it so much easier. And then they had a deal 50% off all 2-day passes, which made it worth it.
I highly recommend staying at the hotel. It's a fantasy hotel, but you can get just a plain, simple room for quite a bit cheaper. But just having a hotel at the mall, being able to at any time just go to your room, and it's just super handy.
Mm-hmm. You could walk around the mall any time you wanted to as well. Oh, we did the aquarium too, so Sea Turtle.
Aquarium was really small, but.
Yeah, the Sea Turtle and. Sea Turtles,
but
penguins.
I guess it's in the mall, so.
Sea lions. Yeah, it was very small. It must be something.
Must be wildlife. My guess to elk or mountain goats. Yeah, there's an elk on the left hand side.
Oh, look at this.
Huge rack.
Oh, yeah. He's beautiful.
Yep, they're not approaching him, so they're doing okay. And they've pulled all the way off the road. It's not the worst tourist activity that I've seen people. With us. I guess, like you said, if we had time, it would be worth getting the pass and kayak and these things.
This is already almost an 11-hour drive, though.
Yeah, we were thinking about taking the Icefield Highway from Jasper to Banff, but yeah, 11-hour drive. I'm not too eager to make it a 13-hour drive. Very dry. Fire danger extreme. No, not extreme. It said very high fire danger.
It's definitely getting dry and hot out somewhere. It's definitely here.
It says 29 now Celsius.
To find the energy to unpack you. grocery shopping than I'm really.
Yeah.
And laundry.
Yeah.
Yeah. No energy found. At least the hotel bed was comfortable.
Yes. Both the cabin, Drumheller, and the hotel, very comfortable beds. Goats around.
Yeah, which is different.
Just depending on the time of day and weather.
Well, that was still part of your habit to try to wave to bigger drivers.
Oh, am I waving?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, I guess they're not even seeing me.
No. They barely noticed the kayaks and about it.
I didn't even realize I was waving at bigger drivers. Just a little four-wheeler. But that was burnt on at a couple of days in a row, so it's not as bad that way. Mm. Like, he wasn't in pain. It's like discomfort. Let's try the sunglasses on. Yeah, I think there's some nice new sunglasses that I have now. Thanks.
Great.
beautiful mountainscape here.
I haven't been this way in a while, so I'm just watching.
Planes at the airport. At least three. Four. Behind each other. Four airplanes.
We're gonna fly in here and go camping.
Yep, fly in here and go camping. Alright, key in front of me. It'd be awesome if you used cruise control. That way I can match your speed now. Speeding up and slowing down is starting to get old. That's where the, what's the cruise control? Adaptive cruise control would be nice. Or just distance myself from the car in front of us. We've got to plan a vacation too, just Jasper here. Got a whole week to just hang out in these mountains.
Mm-hmm. There's a couple things I want to revisit.
Or go to a couple different campsites between Banff and Jasper. He's got their faraway flashes on. I'm just turning them off. Kia, pick a lane. email or tell Mike thanks for sunglasses.
That's not what I want.
Oh. I can text them to you and say.
Yeah, you could.
I could do that. Yeah. Office, not right now. I guess that big mountain over there, on the left-hand side, way in the background, is Edith Cavell. The sign was pointing at. Give him a little space between them and me.
That road has a lot of fun stuff up that way.
Yeah, we've driven up that way.
Lake and canyon. And
beautiful deep canyons and hiking trails. River has cut some beautiful, beautiful deep, deep canyons in the stone there.
Well worth a visit.
Speeding like crazy, yeah.
Especially since we know they patrol this park like crazy.
Yeah.
Is it third cap I think we've seen today, though?
What?
Third cap we've seen?
Third, yep, third. Fourth.
Fourth?
Yeah.
Okay. Been a few. We're out today.
In front of me is. Lots of space. I can just have cruise control on and relax for a bit.
Yeah.
realize just because there's one cop there doesn't mean there's not another one down the road. Yeah, I'm starting to get hungry. Mm-hmm.
There's loaded places. Last night we did the old spaghetti factory, and that was pretty tasty.
Yeah, I didn't even order a big meal there. Lucky. You had a stoplight, the same spot a cop is. Mm-hmm. No souvenir for you today. So if we wanted to do the glacial drive and all that, we have to go south here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Ice fields everywhere. Good, we've got space between us again. Looks like I'm gonna sneeze. Excuse me, I'll blow my nose. Sneezing feeling has gone away. That did the trick. Banger.
It works.
Does the job really good on fuel economy? Basically, it costs us $200 to drive to Drumheller. It costs us a little more driving back home.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe $220, $230. Speed limit is still 70 here. Although it doesn't feel like it should be. It feels like it should be at least 90 or 100.
Yeah, we usually get a woman shot of elk around here. What they do for.
Well, there's a whole bunch of tents in there.
Yeah, some construction stuff.
Pipeline construction, they're sleeping in tents.
Not afraid of the bears.
It's a big group of tents, which are right. It's 90. Yeah, this is quite a beautiful drive, a relaxing drive. It's funny how driving has been the most relaxing event on this vacation.
I've been so busy.
We're approaching the Continental Divide.
It should be coming up soon.
All these rivers are flowing the opposite direction we're driving in. So as we hit the Continental Divide, we'll have all the rivers flowing the same direction we're driving in. Okay, bud. Been on my bumper for a bit now. Just pass me. I've got cruise control on. At least he backed off. Thank you. I'm thinking I'm not going to call Kenworth. Just leave the truck locked up. Mm-hmm. Just leave home Monday morning. 6 in the morning, head to the yard at 6:30. Gate should be open by 6:30. And then go drive north, get my trailer. Sunday off. Yeah, for us it's Saturday. You guys are watching this on a Friday, but for us it's a Saturday. So sniffly.
I'm gonna say you're sick, but you already said you're not sick. Well, I can't say you're injured, and I don't know what to call you.
Park entrance from the opposite direction. Well, not entrance, the gate. Get your tickets, pay your tickets. If you're planning on staying in the park. So yeah, saw one elk this time. One moose last time. Not much. Lots of beautiful mountains.
It's a beautiful day for a drive. You only had that one day of rain, so
yeah.
It wasn't bad.
One rainy day on vacation. We picked that day to go do the museum and stuff, so. Yo, Continental Divide. Welcome to British Columbia. Mount Robson Provincial Park. Got that wrong 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, but it doesn't tell you.
Doesn't say, yeah.
Change your times.
Time zone.
Be there really at once.
It's going from 11 o'clock to 10 o'clock. You look at that. 10:04. We started the video at 10:10.
You're funny.
I guess we just have to record another hour. Poured this bug wash in, was there still some winter stuff left in there?
A little bit, yeah.
A little bit?
Yeah.
Next time should be a little stronger bug wash. guess you're allowed to yawn.
Yeah.
Short night.
Short night before that.
Thanks to me. Yellowhead Lake, boat launch. Yellowhead Mountain to our right hand side, so you guys can't see it, but that's where the Yellowhead Mountain is. Alright, we can't see it either. Too many trees.
I can see it.
You can see it?
I don't know.
Glimpses through the trees. We've reached our hour. If I don't feel worse, I'll be back on the road on Monday. If I feel worse, I'll give you guys an extra video. I have a feeling I'm feeling better every day. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the ride through Jasper National Park and part of Mount Robson Provincial Park. There's the Fraser River. Pretty small up here. We are out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for all the new subscribers. For the members that have shown up as well. Members list is slowly getting longer. So if you guys want to watch the bonus video on the weekend, hit us up on the membership list, get your name on the credits, and you only have to pay 99 cents Canadian. So it's not putting it there to make money, I'm putting it there for those of you that want to support me. It's there. I am out of here.
What?
Oh, we are out of here.
That's better.
You guys rock.
Adios.